experts. They not only install, but will guide you if you want to install yourself. Woodland Stoves and Fireplaces has over 35 working wood, gas, and electric units on display at the corner of East Franklin and Riverside Avenue in Minneapolis. Woodland Stoves and Fireplaces, out of the ordinary products and services.
With your AM 950 weather, I'm Brett Johnson. Look for sunny skies today with a high near 71. Tonight, partly cloudy with a low around 44. And Thursday, a chance for rain with a high around 57. Discover the magic of Crooner's Supper Club. From the incredible shows to the cozy ambiance of Maggie's Lounge, there's no better place to spend an evening with friends, family, or that special someone. Crooner's Supper Club is located off Moore Lake and Highway 65. More at croonersloungemn.com.
Portions of the following program may be pre-recorded.
Broadcasting live on AM 950, the Progressive Voice of Minnesota, as well as WCPT 820 Chicago's Progressive Talk at Night. It is the Matt McNeil Show for your Wednesday. Good to have you with us today. 952-946-6205, 952-946-6205 is the phone number. Patrick, how are you today?
I'm doing pretty well. How are you?
I'm doing great because for the folks in Chicago, which once again, I was down in Chicago this last weekend, and they're already kind of greening up and looking a little nice. Got some daffodils out, looking very pretty, Chicago. I like Chicago. Chicago's a good town, man. It's pretty. I do love flowers, and I do love the green, especially after winter. You look good. Here in Minneapolis, we have actually made that turn. It is like 60. It's a Lake Huron summer right now. It's, if you're up on the UP of Michigan, it's a Lake Huron summer. It's 65 degrees and sunny skies right now, and the bugs have come out already. God. Can you give us one day? One day? No, you're not going to give us one day. All right. A lot to get to today. Once again, Stein joining us, coming up at his usual spot. For the local folks here in the 4 o'clock hour, John Fugelsang is going to join us to talk about Sexy Liberal Coming to Town. That is the beginning of the 4 o'clock hour. And if you're in Chicago, you can always podcast that at your favorite podcast places. By all means, enjoy. Bon appetit. 952-946-6205. 952-946-6205 is the phone number. I want to start off with, it's a bit of breaking news, and it is a little bit local here, but it kind of plays into, it does kind of play into the main topic I want to get into the beginning of the show here. Minnetonka is a suburb to the west of Minneapolis. It is a second-tier suburb of the Twin Cities. An exchange of gunfire in Minnetonka neighborhood late Wednesday morning left an officer wounded, a city spokesperson said. The shooting occurred on Crestwood Drive as the warrant was being issued by Hennepin County Sheriff's Office, apparently according to a Minnetonka City spokesperson. Law enforcement agents from around the metro were responding to the scene near Interstate 494 and Excelsior Boulevard as the early afternoon. There's no immediate word on what prompted the gunfire, whether anyone who else had been injured. Wittenberg said he did not know whether a warrant was for an arrest or for some kind of search. According to law enforcement sources, the injured officer is a deputy with the Hennepin County Sheriff's Office. Hennepin County, and for the folks in Chicago, is the county that Minneapolis itself is in. The spokesperson for Hennepin County Sheriff's Office said he is still gathering information on the incident, couldn't comment. This thing, my phone might go off because I do get these alerts. And so we have been getting alerts. The last I knew that this is still a lockdown situation in this neighborhood, the individual was still inside the house with the weapon. So that's the case maybe. Now I'm going to reiterate something. This is universal for Minneapolis, Chicago, anywhere you're going. If you are pro cop, then you have to be pro gun control. Because once again, I want to make sure we understand something here about what happened here. This was just a warrant being dropped off. Not sure exactly what kind of warrant it was, but it was a warrant being dropped off. And all of a sudden, this turns into a deadly situation. Well, at least it did not now, although once again, an injured officer. That this officer basically was shot because they were just trying to drop off a piece of paper or trying to conduct a search. You cannot be pro-cop unless you are pro-gun control. It's just that simple. Because all these guns everywhere have turned routine operations for police departments into SWAT team, armored vehicles, body shields, shutting down entire neighborhoods. I mean, there's a private school, elementary school, that's right by there. I don't know how they're going to release their kids anytime soon. I'm only imagine that the parents are very concerned about that. My daughter was, their school was off today. I immediately called her to find out, hey, where are you at, by the way, right now? And, you know, she was at an Olive Garden, which that leads to a discussion I'll have to have with her later about, you know, I guess the soup and salad is the breadsticks are a nice option for lunch. I mean, I guess there, but still, I'll have to have a discussion about that, you know, with her a little bit later on. But she was nowhere near that area, that's for sure. And I imagine that a lot of other parents are. But you've got a lot of people who are obviously affected by this, let alone a sheriff's deputy, by the sounds of it. That's the reports that are coming out that are being that this individual is being shot. The guns everywhere world sucks. It doesn't work. And this incident happened after I decided I was going to start talking about the reaction to a story I posted yesterday on social media about, I believe this was in Detroit, a Chipotle restaurant in Detroit, a guy upset about the lack of guac on his burrito, jumped behind the counter to basically try to put a ton of guac on his burrito. When the employee said, no, you're not supposed to be back here, the guy shot him. And I said, if you're at the point where we have a society where people think you should shoot somebody because of the quality and quantity of guacamole on a burrito, you basically, there is your argument. We probably should have a lot less guns in society. Because once again, I guarantee you, that guy was a good guy with a gun until he became a bad guy with a gun. And once again, the good guy with a gun failed to show up to stop bad guy with a gun. The response I got is the standard one. Not everybody, but I did hear from certain people that if he had a gun or if there was an armed guard at the Chipotle, this wouldn't have happened. This is an old discussion I've had. And if you haven't heard me talk about this stuff before, I am a person who is very much for gun control. Guns are ridiculously violent. They basically take a mentally compromised individual and turn them into a lethal weapon. We have had this happen multiple times before. You have people with an agenda will take guns and basically can create a slaughter wherever you're at. As a matter of fact, I mean, Vegas, I mean, we talk about this individual, how he turned that into an absolute nightmare scenario from the higher level of a Vegas hotel. I'll never forget was the Texas right-wing gun group that wanted to prove all these liberal Euro wuss balls at Charlie Hebdo would have been safe if they would have had guns on the premises at the time that their offices were attacked by terrorists. And to their credit, they actually admitted, oh no, we couldn't stop this at all. As a matter of fact, every time we tried, we all died. And the matter of fact, the only people that survived ever were the people that headed for the exits the second the bullets started to fly. This was a pro-gun group that tried over and over and over again to prove that they could John McClane it at Nakatomi Plaza and win the day. And they failed spectacularly. And you know why? Is because guns are just that lethal. A mentally compromised individual can become a killing machine. In this case in Minnetonka, here is a trained police officer, weapon on his hip, probably wearing some body armor, thank God. And he could not pull the gun fast enough to stop what was about to happen. Why? Because a mentally compromised individual becomes basically lethal. the argument I made on social media that got some people upset basically boils down to this argument. Republicans and these gun kooks think that the safest America is the one which has everyone walking around like it's the Walking Dead. A gun drawn at all times in their hand, loaded, round in the chamber, safety off, finger on the trigger, constantly targeting everyone around them. It's insanity. And when they say, well, we're not saying that's the world. Yeah, they are. I want to go back to school shootings, because the argument that the gun kooks make is that if the teacher was armed, they could have stopped that guy right away. So let's talk. I've done this before for the Minneapolis audience, for Chicago. Let's just talk this out a second. All right. So the presumption you're making is that the first classroom that this psychopath kicks the door open and starts spraying with bullets, that the teacher is going to have a gun ready, at the ready to stop them. Mind you, avoiding bullets like the Matrix, I guess, while the children in the classroom are being ripped to pieces by an assault weapon designed for military combat. That would require, and once again, the teacher is probably doing this under fire with zero warning, much like these police officers who have extensive training. But this teacher is a chemistry teacher and all of a sudden has to become John McClane at Nakatomi Plaza. For this to even have a chance of being successful, the weapon has to, at the very least, be on their hip, more than likely be in their hand at that point. The round has got to be in the chamber. The safety has got to be off. Their finger has got to be in the trigger, and they've got to pull that weapon up. And I guess the Republican argument is that it's going to just be a lucky shot, because they're not going to have time to do what we were trained to do in the military and get into a safe firing position to be able to target and shoot. You've got bullets flying all around you, including at you. If you haven't been hit, your only chance is to whip that gun up and basically be able to fire around and hope it hits the target. That's insanity. So that's when you say, well, if this person had a gun, if the guy making the burritos, let that sink in for a second, had a gun on him at all times, loaded, rounded, maybe he could have stopped this. What are you freaking talking about? Because even in their best case scenario, in the best case world scenario, there's no way in the world when a crazed individual starts firing off rounds that anyone can do anything about it unless the gun is in their hand, safety off, finger on the trigger, and they've got a round in the chamber. That's the only way they can pull that off. That's the only way. And so this is not my standard. This is the gun kook standard. Which, let me get back to this with the Chipotle when I do return from the break. It is the Matt McNeil Show on a Wednesday.
Hey, it's Tom Harbin to tell you about the professionals at All Energy Solar. Making the switch to solar energy can save you money on your monthly energy bills. Plus, you can have peace of mind knowing that you're powering your property on renewable energy, not fossil fuels. So declare your independence from the fossil fuel industry by switching to All Energy Solar. All Energy Solar has been leading Minnesotans toward a cleaner future since 2009, and they've developed a proven process for all of their projects. All Energy Solar's professionals will help you through the entire process, from a free site assessment to custom designs that work for your property. Plus, they offer EV charging and battery storage systems. All Energy Solar's professionals can help you find out about the benefits solar can have for your property. Just visit allenergysolar.com for more information and to get your free solar site assessment. Call 800-620-3370 or visit allenergysolar.com.
Hi, my name is Caddy from Minnesota Recovery Connection.
And I'm Erin with Minnesota Recovery Connection.
We'd like you to listen to our show, Redefining Recovery, A Recovery Revolution. It is on Saturdays at 10 a.m. on AM 950.
On the show, we discuss topics about addiction, understanding substance use disorder, the many pathways to recovery, and finding your personal journey.
Listen to Redefining Recovery Saturdays at 10 a.m. and find our podcast on your favorite app.
I'm Rachel Schroman, owner of Schroman Law, and I believe you deserve information. Our firm offers free quarterly estate planning seminars at our office in St. Paul. At these seminars, you can learn the basics of estate planning from an attorney to help you determine which estate planning documents will meet your needs and goals in an efficient and cost-effective manner. You can learn more and register at our website, schromanlaw.com/events. That's schromenlaw.com/events.
Spot on, nice fish.
Nice walleye. Look at that.
Beautiful.
Minnesota gold right there.
This is the first restaurant in the world that strictly is decolonized menu.
All right, let's try the soup.
Oh man, that's good. So earthy and mushroomy.
Where's the seals?
It looks like the ocean.
It's not that cold.
It is that wet though.
What will your Minnesota travel story be? Discover what makes Minnesota the star of the North at ExploreMinnesota.com.
Sponsored by Explore Minnesota Tourism, aired by the Minnesota Broadcasters Association and this station.
Seward Co-op is now offering convenient self-serve and prepackaged hot options and salad bars at both the Franklin and Friendship stores. Breakfast items available daily until 11 a.m. and brunch served all day every Sunday. Their weekly lunch and dinner menus highlight cuisines from around the world. They offer vegan, vegetarian, and gluten-free options daily. 95% of the ingredients used are organic from small-scale, local community food producers whenever possible. More at seward.coop.
It is the Matt McNeil Show once again on your Wednesday. Still no updates. The last information I had on that shooting of an officer in Minnetonka, Minnesota, they have not had any updates on that. 952-946-6205. 952-946-6205. So let me get back to once again. Republicans, the argument is, well, when someone should have shot him, you should have had a gun. You should be able to stop them. And Patrick, during the break, actually, you brought up, Patrick, why don't you go ahead? You brought up a very good point about when we talked about this with school teachers, arming teachers and what they're supposed to do when someone opens fire on their classroom with an automatic weapon. You brought up one thing I forgot to mention as far as the insanity of what we're asking teachers to do in that situation.
Well, a lot of these guys come in with heavy tactical armor that, you know, one shot from a 9mm is probably not going to take this guy down unless you, as you said, get a lucky shot and maybe hit him in the head. But, you know, just blasting at him is not going to take some of these guys down with how much tactical armor they're coming in with.
You know, and once again, when you talk about the school shooter, you're talking about a biology teacher. You're not talking about special forces. You're not talking about a well-trained military unit or a police unit. No, you're talking about a biology teacher. You're talking about, a literature teacher that's trying to get to pull this off, a fourth grade teacher, a band teacher. Not only, you know, there's the mentally crazed individual that's firing rounds is firing off something that's shooting 20 to 30 rounds per every 5 to 10 seconds. And you are going to, at best, have one chance, one round to hit this person. And that gun has, like I said, it's got to be in your hand, safety off, round in the chamber. You're not going to have even time to aim it. You're just going to have to get the luckiest shot of all time. And once again, as Patrick said, you're hoping that the guy doesn't have body armor on, because then it becomes even a lot trickier. No, it's, you know, let's apply this to the Chipotle situation. So you're saying to me, because once again, all of a sudden, a gun comes out, round goes off. The only way you're going to be able to defend yourself, because once again, if you're at a point where people are shooting people because of guacamole, for God's sakes, or someone dropping off a warrant, you really have lost it. You can't sit there and say, well, if they know there are guns everywhere, there already are guns everywhere. That's a false argument.
They know there are guns anywhere, and they're still shooting people because of guacamole. So now your only argument is, well, the guy that was making the burrito, he needs to be armed. And once again, let's go to the scenario. As he's making a burrito, he has to have a gun at the ready, safety off, round in the chamber to ward off this sort of thing. Oh, Matt, well, they could have an armed guard in the restaurant. Oh, that's good. Because once again, same thing. Someone starts firing off a round. You're already too late in that scenario. But let's just say that this armed guard in the Chipotle, because that's what America is, I guess, now. He has to basically have the gun out, aiming, targeting, trying to target people like it's a freaking zombie show, man. No, your entire argument is broken and wrong and failed. You cannot make all these guns work. The biggest mistake that we have made as a country, as far as our, you know, safety, is to take the wheelbarrows with the guns and dump them into the town square and think that this somehow is going to make us safer. We never used to have this level of carnage. Of course there were shootings. Of course there were, but it's not like it is today. And the reason why things have gotten so crazy is because we teach people guns are the way you solve problems. You didn't get enough guacamole on your burrito? Shoot him. And it's only after the fact, like, well, we didn't mean for him to shoot him. But then it's you criticize the employee for not having a gun, or the store for not having an armed guard out there on watch with a weapon pulled, targeting everybody looking to get a freaking quesadilla. It's insanity. And you can sit there and argue that, well, no one's saying this. No, you are saying this. If you're saying the employee of the restaurant should be armed, then let's talk about that. If you're going to say that the school teacher is going to be armed so that they can stop a shooter, well, let's just expose the lunacy of it. Like I said, we went. I got to give credit for that Texas gun group that tried to prove that the liberal Euro hippies could have saved themselves at Charlie Hebdo, and they couldn't. They tried over and over. They knew they were coming in the door. They had the guns at the ready, and they still couldn't stop the shooters. So no, this is not the option. The option is not to basically arm more people, because all you're going to do is that guy gets shot. And then all of a sudden, the deranged man who started shooting because he didn't get enough guacamole has two guns. This is why it's so disingenuous. It's that no one's saying that. Well, then what are you saying? Because that's exactly what you're saying. Because gunfire is instantaneous. The problem here is, and they'll say, well, no, the guns don't fire themselves. Exactly. Cars don't drive themselves either, but we got tons of laws out the book about basically making sure you can't drink and drive or drive recklessly. We just had some guy the motorcycle rider was driving 135 miles an hour or something like that. Well, they arrested him. Why? Because he was being reckless. The motorcycle didn't drive himself. The individual was on the motorcycle. Was the individual going 135? No, the motorcycle was doing. But we still don't basically say, well, he was just going along for the ride. The gun is the vehicle of chaos. That's all it is. The gun is the vehicle of chaos. And it allows mentally deranged individuals to become lethal regardless of their mental derangement. So here we are yet once again with law enforcement just trying to drop off a piece of paper or conduct a search, all of a sudden becoming targets because guns everywhere. Maybe, just maybe, if we regulated the guns, we wouldn't have to arm every police department like it's a military commando unit. The guns do not make us safer. If anything, they clearly make us a lot less safe. And once again, the entire argument they try to make is, well, you can't compare us to other countries because America. No, we can compare ourselves to other countries because we can regulate guns. Well-regulated militia in the Second Amendment basically means you can regulate it. Even Scalia acknowledged that. And we used to have laws. This is about Republicans making sure wheelbarrows where the guns are dropped off in the town squares with no regulation and no accountability. And then when those guns get used in the most aggressive way possible, it's not the gun's fault. It's not the shooter's fault. It's everybody else's fault for not stopping the shooter. Screw you. You're welcome. This is such a broken system. It's insane. Let's take a break. Come on back. Jeff Stein, when we do return, it is the Matt McNeil Show.
This is Chad, owner of AM950. After the hailstorm last year, we had a number of people stop by the station letting us know we had damage. That's when I called our trusted contractor, Snap Construction. Turns out we didn't have any damage and our roof was still in good health. Ryan, is it common to hear you have damage when you don't?
Chad, this can happen more times than not. At Snap Construction, we'll give you a thorough assessment and let you know the condition of your roof. We are trusted by a number of insurance agents in the metro to give them just that, an honest assessment. Last year's storm is just starting to reveal damage on homes that didn't show damage last year. If you were in the path of a storm and were denied, it's worth an extra look. Freezing, thawing conditions, and spring rains will wash away the damaged granules that are covering up damage from last year's storm.
Call Snap Construction, arguably the most well-reviewed exterior contractor in the metro area, at 612-333-SNAP or find them online at snapconstruction.com.
It's Brad Friedman, host of the Bradcast, weeknights at 7 on AM 950. KTNF, St. Louis Park, Minneapolis, St. Paul, the progressive voice of Minnesota.
Mental health and substance use disorders are complex, stigmatizing, and can be overwhelming issues for families to face. Finding the right diagnosis and care can sometimes feel impossible, especially when you don't know where to start looking. Hazelden Betty Ford understands what your family is going through. Hazelden Betty Ford's patient access team will direct you towards a clear path forward, in-network with most insurances. This message is brought to you by Hazelden Betty Ford, the Minnesota Broadcasters Association, and this station.
AM 950, KTNF, St. Louis Park, Minneapolis, St. Paul.
Hey, it's Patrick for Zero Res. I'm going to get right into it. You should call Zero Res to beat the spring cleaning rush with big savings and priority booking by calling our cleaning heroes today. You should think about the dust, dander, and bacteria that's been breeding in your carpet all winter long with nowhere to go. And don't forget about your air ducts. If they're dirty, your air quality suffers. Indoor air quality is an issue year-round, but all that pollen is getting ready to come out of hibernation and into your home. This month, get 3-room Zero Resified starting at just $129 and take $75 off any air duct cleaning. You owe it to yourself and your family to breathe happy, healthy, and clean. Call 952-ZERO-RES or go to ZeroResMinnesota.com and ask for the AM 950 special. Zero Res, backward or forward, spells the same.
With your AM 950 weather, I'm Brett Johnson. Look for sunny skies today with a high near 71. Tonight, partly cloudy with a low around 44. And Thursday, a chance for rain with a high around 57. And make sure you go on our Facebook page and interact with one of our sexy liberal posts. If you do, you'll be entered into our Wheel of Destiny drawing, where you'll have a chance to win a pair of tickets to both our Sexy Liberal pre-party and the Sexy Liberal show. We'll do our Wheel of Destiny drawing today during the 4 o'clock hour. Again, go to AM950's Facebook page.
Jeff Stein's our national and presidential expert, noted author. You can find his books at your favorite book location, as well as also the Iowa Business Report, the Iowa Politics Report. They come to us from his mothership, the KXEL Cedar Falls Waterloo, where he's kind enough to join us today. Hi, Jeff.
Your favorite book location? I believe we call them stores, but, you know.
Are you in the Library of Congress yet? I mean, we should check that.
Yes.
Of course. You have to be.
Like you're going to know how to check. Yes, they have numbers and everything. And you send copies to the Library of Congress. See, that's the scam, by the way.
Yes.
The Library of Congress operates by requiring that you have these numbers, but you have to send two copies of the book. I mean, their budget is nothing. People are sending them free books all the time. I mean, it's a scam. I'm telling you, it's a scam, McNeil.
But you got your Dewey Decimal, don't you? You got your Dewey Decimal, like 9-digit long decimal, too.
Oh, I did the plus four, just like my zip code. I did the plus four. Absolutely. Don't want anything to get misdelivered here.
The first person who liked my picture of me staring at a deep dish pizza in Chicago just I'm surprised you are not ripping me to shreds for having the greatest look of joy in my life at a piece of food, man.
You have been married a long time. You have three tremendous children, thanks to your wife's influence.
Yeah, indeed.
And you're sitting there drooling at Chicago deep dish pie, which is tremendous. That's not the point of it.
Oh.
But what's sad is you posted it. I saw it. I said, good Lord. And of course I liked it and reposted it because that's what you do. And then one of my broadcast buddies in Nevada, of all places, responds to it and says, he's not wrong.
It's not. No, that's, I mean, my kids only wish I looked like that when they were born. I mean, it really was.
At any point since. none of them are married yet, right?
Not yet, no.
That's the look, is when the kid is married and you're like, that's it, I'm done. You're going to see the look just like Chicago pie.
Well, if we have Chicago pie at the wedding, which, you know, I'm not against. that could be the menu item right there. absolutely. I think about that in a heartbeat. Okay, so
Heart is still beating as opposed to the clogged arteries, that is.
No, yeah, you know what? You take it in a little bit at a time. It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. That's right.
Atta, buddy, it's a marathon. Yes, sir. Speaking of which,
pardon me while I was putting up that window, I got a little lightheaded. Oh god. Anyway, I want to start off with something. You and I, we've talked a lot about court cases.
Mm-hmm.
But we really haven't broken down the hush money case, which I think we need to do, because Trump is like a trout in the bottom of a boat at this point, flopping around trying to get out of this one. And I was thinking to myself, okay, how dangerous is this trial for him? Because he seems to be working harder than in Atlanta with the RICO case down there to get this one at least delayed, moved, or anything. He's frantically trying to do anything he can to delay this. How, in regards to the hush money case, how dangerous is this case for him?
I'm going to take a little different view in terms of the flurry of activity, and here's why. Well, first of all, it's next. So, you know, it's like full court press.
It's Monday. Right? If nothing delays it, it's Monday.
It's next in the agenda, so that's where the attention is. It is not a complicated case. And that's why you may be seeing such a flurry. Not necessarily that it's the riskiest one for him, but it's the least complicated, meaning once the trial starts, it's going to get over quickly. How long's the trial in Atlanta going to take?
Oh, it's going to take years, years and years.
Well, that's my point. So in other words, he's furiously trying to move the case that can get resolved quickly. Because if there is a conviction, you've read the same polls that I have that say strong Trump supporters might be moved if there's an actual conviction. Now, I don't know that they feel that this is the conviction and it's the same level as some of the others, but it's one of these cases that's not going to take a long time to try. The elements are pretty basic about it. And I don't know that it's a slam dunk. You've already got the judge who's made comments about Michael Cohen and, is he going to commit perjury by coming in because he's got inconsistent statements, that kind of thing. But the bottom line is, it's the sort of case that can be resolved quickly. And that's why they want everything unresolved in November. That's the bottom line. No case resolved until after the election.
Well, and that E. Jean Carroll, you know, verdict. I mean, it is a bit of a sliding scale on these things. I mean, it's
right.
It's
criminal. That was not, I mean, heinous if you believe the allegations, but not criminal
guilty of the allegations, by the way, too. Well, again,
it's a civil case. It's an entirely different standard than a criminal case.
What's interesting about this is that you know, obviously, and there was the one case about McDougal. Was it McDougal who was the Playboy playmate? Playmate Karen McDougal. She barely is the witness that I think Trump's most scared of, because it shows a pattern of behavior here that backs up Stormy Daniels. And you've got basically people buying off witnesses, or you know, victims, I guess it would be the better word. The allegation is you're buying off victims and shutting them down through these National Enquirer and stuff like this.
Where
does this go? Because I think has been under the radar. Could Trump go to jail with this case if he is found guilty in it?
Well, again, the whole point of it is that money was paid to buy silence. And the reason the silence was bought was to not harm his election chances. And therefore, the money paid would have to be tracked as a campaign-related expense. And it wasn't, which therefore would be falsifying financial documents in a campaign. And that's a federal charge. And you don't have a lot of discretion in federal cases. I mean, that's the long view of the whole thing.
And by the way, good point on the federal cases thing is that those federal cases are a lot more streamlined for the most part.
They are. And from a punishment standpoint, there's no probation in the federal system.
No.
You know, I mean, when you're sentenced to 10 years at the Gray Bar Hotel, you serve 10 years at the Gray Bar Hotel. It's not like it's suspended, it's et cetera, et cetera. Now, remind me about your friend, the Playboy Playmate. I already forgot her name.
Karen McDougal. She was, okay. She now, was, and just, you know, for the background there, National Choir publisher David Pecker had basically done the same thing that he tried to do with Stormy Daniels, which was, you know, this is a pattern of behavior that they basically would, there'd be an allegation against Trump that one of these, you know, tabloids would swoop in, offer a check, and then basically threaten to shut them down if they spoke anything about it.
How long a pattern of payoffs was there? And here's what I'm getting at. If Ms. McDougal in 2014 had made the allegation and it was paid off, the pattern you're establishing is that they pay people off, not tied to an election. In other words, if you show a behavior of payoffs over the course of time, and this is just simply the latest one, that hurts if you're trying to say it's tied to an election. If Ms. McDougal was paid off contemporaneous with the election, you have a different pattern.
Well, and I'm going to counterpoint that to you. Just because Trump wasn't running for office when Karen McDougal happened,
right,
is you know, he himself got himself into an election. No one, he wasn't one day saying, what do you mean I'm running for office? The fact that he then didn't understand it. I actually will go the other way. And once again, it's the argument would be he has a pattern of behavior where he basically people are claiming they're victims of his. They get bought off by a tabloid and these allegations kind of would disappear. He just didn't realize doing it when you're running for office has different complications. So, and the argument, what I'd say is that it makes it easier into a point to prove the case. Understandably, you know, I think it's harder. Wouldn't you agree it would be harder with the previous experience to basically say, well, this is not something that, you know, really had anything to do with the election?
Well, okay. Now, one small thing.
Yeah.
Has Ms. Daniels or Ms. McDougal have either claimed that there were forced relations, or was it a consensual relationship, one night relationship?
I don't think it's so cut and dry.
Okay, it may not be.
I don't think it's so cut and dry. I think there was an agreement for something, and you know,
my point is
spanking with a magazine with his face on the cover. I mean, it's you know, things go down different paths. How about we say it like that?
Okay, that's good thing. This show's on in Chicago at night. My point is, I'm not sure they're victims in the sense others are victims. And I just want, I want to be very careful.
Eugene Carroll is, I think, is a different case than this.
That's what I'm getting at. I don't want all of it to be, I want to be very careful about terminology, but that's, it's a minor point. No, I would say if the idea was let's pay someone off to keep details of a consensual relationship secret, and if that was done prior to contemplating running for president, if he then did it again later, the payoff, I think it's harder to say that the pattern is going, that the pattern is established and therefore he's guilty of the election fraud. You don't need a pattern for the election fraud.
Yeah. Yes.
All you need to do is just say, and so that's why the pattern stuff, I think gets in the way. If there's some way to show, look, you got to shut this woman up so that she doesn't spill the beans during the election. Now, Mikey Cohen, go pay her off. Yes, he might have used the same methodology and non-disclosure agreements, et cetera, as in the past, but it's a very targeted thing this time. And so, again, the issues, as with so many things concerning Mr. Trump, the issues all get blurred. When we're in court, we've got to be very specific. And I think that's the easiest way to understand the case is to have it at its base level. And a good prosecutor, that's all they need, really.
One of the people that's expected to testify is Hope, and I can't remember her last name, but his former personal assistant, Hope.
Is it Hicks?
Hope Hicks, yep. Mm-hmm. Hope Hicks is expected to testify in this case. Mm-hmm. I got to imagine that Trump does not want that to happen in any capacity as well, even with a delayed trial in any in this way. Mm-hmm. But, you know, this is once again one of these people that's, you and I have talked about inner circles. You get, you know, he's protected. There's rings around him that mm-hmm. keep him protected. Hope Hicks is right there on the next mm-hmm. level outside from him. Mm-hmm. That's got to be something that, if, you know, she knows a lot of things that went on within the Trump campaign presidency, as well mm-hmm. as his regular business dealings as well.
She has never been accused of anything or charged with anything, to my knowledge, correct?
Exactly. It's more of a witness issue.
No. But here's the distinguishing point. Wasn't it just today that his former tax attorney got a second sentence
for lying? Yeah.
Or five months.
He's in Rikers right now, man.
And then after that, here's your 5 months of federal time, which, as we've already established, is not waived. Inner circle is different when you are the defendant. Now, that guy took the fall. Remember, we've been talking about that. And that was the whole idea of Michael Cohen in a different realm of there are layers of deniability and, you know, you fall on your sword and we take care of you. And that's what Alan, I don't know, Weisberg, I can't recall the man's name. Hope Hicks is in a different category. And she also left the White House at a certain point. So again, she's not a target. And that does make her, in one respect, more interesting because, you know, what's Trump's people going to say about Cohen? And he's a bad witness and a bad example, but they're going to say, well, which story do you believe? Which time under oath was he lying? Well, he told this story to save his skin. She's not in that situation. That changes the whole dynamic of the testimony, to your point.
Well, and also it brings you back your point about the federal charges is that you can go character assassinate all day long. If you still paid the money, you paid the money. And that's the problem with the federal charge on this. That'll be interesting. Cannon, by the way, one last thing here. Cannon mm-hmm. has moved that trial away from June. So more than likely, the documents case in Florida is not going to happen anytime before the election at this point. Let's take a break. Come on back. Jeff Stein joining us. We'll talk about Marjorie Taylor Greene trying to implode the Republican Party again in the House. It is the Matt McNeil Show on a Wednesday. Okay, how could I forget? Hey,
it takes some courage to bet. Get ready to party before Stephanie Miller's Sexy Liberal Tour on April 13th. Join us at AM 950 Sexy Liberal pre-party at On the Rocks, conveniently located above the Nicollet Diner at the end of Nicollet Mall. It's the perfect spot to mingle with your fellow Sexy Liberal fans and some of your favorite AM 950 hosts. Our pre-party is from 4:30 until 7 o'clock. Enjoy the delightful patio at On the Rocks, weather permitting. Admission is just $35 and includes light appetizers and two drink tickets. Again, that's our sexy liberal pre-party April 13th from 4:30 till 7 o'clock at On the Rocks. Pre-party tickets are available for purchase at am950radio.com. But that's not all. Let's talk more about the main event. Keep an eye on our Facebook pages for posts about the Sexy Liberal Show. Engage with these posts for a chance to win a pair of tickets to both our pre-party and the main Sexy Liberal Show. And if you want to guarantee your spot at the Sexy Liberal Show, secure your tickets in advance by finding the ticket link at am950radio.com.
Greg Bakken here. I've told you about the out-of-the-world roast beef sandwiches at Maverick's Real Roast Beef, but I haven't told you about their Philly steak sandwiches, turkey bacon avocado sandwich, BLT, crispy chicken, fish sandwiches, brisket, or pulled pork. Okay, you get the idea. They make a lot of delicious food to the same standard as their famous roast beef sandwiches, and now I'm starving. I'm going to go to Maverick's Real Roast Beef off Lexington and Roseville, and you need to go too. Check out their menu at mavericksbeef.com.
End-of-life decisions are not easy to make. Hi, I'm Mary T. of Mary T. Hospice Care. It's important to make sure that this difficult time is meaningful and comforting to you and your loved ones. Our hospice team provides an individualized program of physical, emotional, spiritual, and practical care so your loved one is comfortable and not in pain. At Mary T. Hospice, we understand that choosing the right hospice care provider can be overwhelming, but we're here to assist you. Learn more today at MaryTInc.com.
This is Chad, owner of AM950. I want to tell you about a better, more environmentally friendly way to care for your lawn with Natural Lawn. Natural Lawn has been treating Minnesota lawns for more than 20 years with organic-based natural products that feed the soil without unnecessary chemicals. That means an envy-worthy, healthier lawn that's safer for your family and your furry friends. Natural Lawn has no contracts and is 100% satisfaction guaranteed. So let Natural Lawn handle your lawn care so you can enjoy your lawn. More at naturallawn.com.
The 2024 Consumer Reports Best Vehicle Edition is out, and once again, Toyotas from Rudy Luther Toyota dominate the field. Four Toyota models make their top picks for 2024, the Prius, the Camry Hybrid Prime, the RAV4 Prime, and the Highlander Hybrid. Consumer Reports recommends all the following Toyotas: the Prius Prime, the Corolla Hybrid, the Camry Hybrid, the Sienna, the Corolla Cross Hybrid, the RAV4 Hybrid, the RAV4 Prime, the Highlander, and the Highlander Hybrid. See for yourself. Visit Rudy Luther Toyota and test drive one today. 394 and 169 in Golden Valley.
Broadcasting in the evening on WCPT 820 Chicago's Progressive Talk, and in the afternoons on AM 950, the Progressive Voice of Minnesota. It is the Matt McNeil Show. Jeff Stein in with his usual Wednesday visit. So Marjorie Taylor Greene, the Republican far right is very upset about, obviously, aid to Ukraine, which we can talk about the complexities of that and who they're taking their barking orders from.
Well, that's the least of it. I mean, yeah. The far right is so upset about everything in the last 8 months.
And Johnson just gets into the position like McCarthy got there. It's easy to sit there and say, I'm going to jam this down their throats. And then all of a sudden you realize, I really can't do that. And we're going to shut down the government and we're all going to take the blame for it. So, you know, Johnson's trying to fall on grenades for the Republicans so they don't shut it down, because that will make them completely unelectable really in an election season. But you just don't have nuance or understanding how political parties work by anyone on this far right group. Apparently Johnson wants to push forward a bill which they brokered with Schumer in the Senate, where it's basically Ukrainian aid, Israeli aid. They're going to push it through. Biden says he's going to sign it, and the Marjorie Taylor Greene and these guys are like, no, we're livid, this is not going to happen. Do you think that, I mean, she's threatening to put a vote out. If it happens, he's gone, and they're once again a rudderless ship. What is your thought on this? I mean, do you think that Johnson's even going to bring that bill up for a vote at this point?
Well, he's got a real problem because of the fact that she wants to make a big deal about what's wrong, but when asked to join the leadership and try to work on solutions, she refused. This is what came out today, is that Johnson offered her a post in his so-called kitchen cabinet. Okay. Like, you know, I want you on the inner circle. I want to hear, you know, I want you in on this. And she said, no, that doesn't work for me. Oh, golly. Okay. So it's real easy to snipe from the outside. This is a broad statement. It's not just her. It's easy to snipe from the outside. It's easy to say, oh man, those radio guys are terrible. If you gave me a show, okay, Chester, help yourself.
Okay. Knock yourself out.
Because you know, the fact of the matter is, and I don't know that she's in such a safe seat these days, but, you know, if you're in a safe seat, yeah, it's a lot easier to be the virtual bomb thrower. You know, rushing up to file the motion to vacate. It's like, well, I'll see if we're going to push this or not. How do you operate with a one vote majority when you've got that hanging over your head at all times? I mean, I just don't see. You and I have talked about this. Go up to any Republican incumbent and say, what have you done that leads to you being reelected? Well, we went back to regular order. We've passed 12 bills. No, you didn't. You combined those 12 bills into two as opposed to one big bill. That's not progress. What else have you done? Well, we were without a speaker for 4 months. Hey, there you go.
And it should be mentioned, your MAGA guys in your district keep screaming that that one bill you passed, those two bills you passed, were highly inferior. So it's not exactly you can't hang a hat on this. Okay, so two things. One, how much of this is Marjorie Taylor Greene thinking she could possibly become the speaker because she can't? But let's face it, she is part of this Twitter troll Republican generation. I've got them here in the state of Minnesota. They're absolute idiots. But they know they couldn't win a statewide race if their life depended on it. And so the only way that she could possibly get into a position of power, and think about it, the third most powerful person in the government as speaker, is if she can somehow strong arm her way into this there. I don't think she has a chance, but do you think that that's part of what her motivation is that's the way she sees that the only way she can grab that brass ring is to do it this way?
Well, first, people on Twitter aren't civil and can't be trusted.
I know.
Twitter. That's not the Twitter X machine. I know. Here's the problem I have with her. Unfriend Matt McNeil. Yeah.
I only wish some of them would. Block me, please. My life will be better.
I beg of you, block me.
Why are you coming to my page? Just leave me alone.
I like Chicago pie. Leave me alone. No, I don't think she wants to be speaker because then you have to be held accountable. But now, that having been said, who had Mike Johnson as speaker on their bingo card?
Exactly.
A year ago, 8 months ago, 6 months ago, no one. So it's not so crazy because everything is lunacy.
Here's the better
put that on t-shirts and rates ready for the station.
Here's the better question.
All right.
If it comes down to, if you are a moderate Republican and your two choices are Hakeem Jeffries as the Democrat speaker or Marjorie Taylor Greene, where do you go? Because
I go to the restroom and I'm not available for the vote.
If one of them does, all of a sudden you're going to have the Democrat in charge. I mean, you're going to have to, everyone has to vote. And so if that becomes the candidate that's up for a vote, you know, I think that this, could we actually see a Democratic speaker of the House with a Republican majority in this really quirky situation?
Sure. Of course you could, because here's the thing. With that one seat majority, let's say you had two Republicans missing for good reason. Okay. They're not hiding. They're just gone. What's to say a Democrat can't file a motion to vacate and insist that it be voted on immediately? Nothing is to keep them from doing that. And that's why Johnson did not force a vote on some of this FISA stuff, because they didn't have enough Republicans in the room. And there was the fear that once things got stirred up, one of the Democrats would say, about that pending motion to vacate, let's bring that up. And they couldn't stop it. That's how crazy, absurd, lunatic this whole thing has become.
When you bring in, and we've got less than a minute here, but when we bring in the Arizona ruling yesterday and the fact that you're Republicans running away from that at top speed,
including Trump,
they're all trying to get away from this, like the in vitro fertilization ruling. You have nothing getting done. You have the clown car in charge of the House. You know, how badly is this damaging the reelection chances of Republicans?
Hugely. And you saw that by Carrie Lake switching her position earlier, before it was a real thing. She said, oh, it's a great law. Well, that doesn't look so good. Now Trump says, oh, that's terrible in Arizona. That's the bellwether. It's going to hurt because there's no message of how to win elections with that far stance.
Find Jeff Stein's books wherever you find books. There you go. Jeff, thank you very much. We'll talk to you next week. Chicago, have a good one. Minneapolis, St. Paul, hour two up next.
You want to feel important? You want to be part of something bigger? Something that matters and that you can help change things? You want to feel like you belong? We felt that way too. I'm Sergeant First Class Chris Hewitt from Glencoe, Minnesota, and that's why we did something about it. We aren't just Minnesota Army National Guard soldiers. We are people just like you. And together, we can make a difference. Take on your legacy. Visit NationalGuard.com/MN to find out more. Sponsored by Minnesota Army National Guard, aired by the Minnesota Broadcasters Association and this station.
Greg Bakken here. Like you, I love good, fresh, delicious food. So I want to tell you about this treasure in Roseville called Maverick's Real Roast Beef. Maverick's has the best roast beef sandwiches I've ever had, made fresh every order. Add fries or onion rings dropped in the fryer when ordered, and you have a winning combination. Maverick's Real Roast Beef has a lot more than roast beef, so check out their website, mavericksbeef.com, or check out their restaurant on Lexington in Roseville.
Come see the Train Chimp. It's the Matt McNeil Show, 3 to 5 p.m. weekday afternoons, right here on AM 950 KTNF, St. Louis Park, Minneapolis, St. Paul.
AP News. I'm Ed Donahue. Israel carried out one of its most high-profile attacks in the war in Gaza, despite calls for Israel to change its tactics. The AP's Sagar Magani has the story.
Israel confirms an airstrike in Gaza killed three sons of Hamas's leader, whom it says were Hamas operatives. The militant group says four of his grandkids were also killed. The deaths threaten to strain efforts to reach a ceasefire. The strike came a day after President Biden said Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's handling of the war is a mistake. Today, he urged Israel to ramp up efforts to get more aid into Gaza.
They're getting in somewhere in the last 3 days, over 100 trucks. It's not enough.
The president says he's been blunt with Netanyahu.
We'll see what he does in terms of meeting the commitments he made to me.
And he's demanding another entry point for aid trucks in northern Gaza. An Israeli official says one will soon open. Sagar Magani, Washington.
On Capitol Hill, Christopher Cavoli, the top general for U.S. forces in Europe, says Ukraine is running out of 155-millimeter shells and will be outgunned by Russia 10 to 1 in weeks without more U.S. help.
The biggest killer on the battlefield is artillery in most conflicts, but in this one, definitely. And should Ukraine run out, they would run out because we stopped supplying because we supply the lion's share of that 155.
Big losses today on Wall Street after the government reported a spike in inflation. It likely means a delay in interest rate cuts by the Federal Reserve. The Biden administration finalized strict limits on certain so-called forever chemicals in drinking water. For a third day in a row, Donald Trump's lawyers are trying to get a New York appeals court to delay his hush money criminal trial. Jury selection is supposed to start Monday. This is AP News.
My brother-in-law died suddenly, and now my sister and her kids have to sell their home. That's why I told my husband we could not put off getting life insurance any longer. An agent offered us a 10-year, $500,000 policy for nearly $50 a month. Then we called SelectQuote. SelectQuote found us identical coverage for only $19 a month, a savings of $369 a year.
Whether you need a $500,000 policy or a $5 million policy, SelectQuote could save you more than 50% on term life insurance.
For your free quote, call SelectQuote at 1-800-452-5050. That's 1-800-452-5050. Or go to SelectQuote.com, 1-800-452-5050. That's 1-800-452-5050.
SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
Details on example rate at selectquote.com.
I'm Angela Warner for Warner Stellium. Sometimes appliances break. Other times you spend years wishing they would. We get it. That's why right now we're paying you to upgrade with our trade-in sale. We'll pay you $50 for each appliance you replace. Our in-store specialists take out the guesswork of wondering what's the best one and which one will fit.
Then Warner Stallion Professional Crews will deliver, install, and take your old stuff away, saving you time and money. So outsource your stress and shop family-owned Warner Stallion.
Experiencing an injury or illness? Wondering if you'll be able to keep your job or when you can return to work? The Minnesota Retain Program may be able to help. Participants may qualify for free support from experts who can guide you through the next steps to get you back to work quickly and safely. Visit mnretain.com or call 507-284-4537 to learn more. Minnesota Retain is fully funded under a grant awarded by the U.S. Department of Labor and the Social Security Administration. This message is brought to you by Minnesota Retain, this station, and the Minnesota Broadcasters Association.
Hi, I'm Scott Chambaud from Chambaud Family Dentistry. We're the fear-free, shame-free dental office. If you're having a dental emergency, we'll try and get you in the same day you call because we don't like to see anyone in pain. And we'll help you get through every appointment in the most pain-free way possible. As my daughter Rachel says,
if you don't see my dad, please see another dentist. Take care of your teeth because they're the only ones you get.
Chamblatt Family Dentistry in Hopkins and St. Paul. Find them online at chamblattfamilydentistry.com or call 1-800-FIX-MY-TEETH.
With your AM 950 weather, I'm Brett Johnson. Look for sunny skies today with a high near 71. Tonight, partly cloudy with a low around 44. And Thursday, a chance for rain with a high around 57. Discover the magic of Crooner's Supper Club. From the incredible shows to the cozy ambiance of Maggie's Lounge, there's no better place to spend an evening with friends, family, or that special someone. Crooner's Supper Club is located off Moore Lake and Highway 65. More at croonersloungemn.com.
Portions of the following program may be pre-recorded.
Hour number two of the show here on your Wednesday. Good to have you with us today, Matt and Patrick. We have got Wheel of Destiny. We'll get to that here in just a little bit. But the big news this week, of course, is the big event coming in this weekend. The Stephanie Miller Sexy Liberal Save the World Comedy Tour, Pantages Theater on Saturday. Tickets still available. We're going to be giving away a bunch a little bit later on this afternoon. Make sure you get there. Of course, Frangela, we talked to them yesterday. Hal Sparks, we're talking to him tomorrow. We had Stephanie on about 2 weeks ago. And John Fugelsang is kind enough to join us once again to talk about coming into town here. Of course, you can hear John on his podcast, which is available on Sirius and available everywhere you get a podcast. And if you're not subscribed, you're wrong. That is brilliant stuff. You can get to that every day or most days. They're weekdays, right, that you put the podcast out?
Podcast is every day, whether you want it or not. Yes.
John, good to see you, my friend.
It's so great to be back on the Matt McNeil show. Can I just say that? You know, Matt McNeil is a legend in the Minneapolis, St. Paul area. And when Matt was first offered his option of parole, a lot of people thought a radio show was not the way to go. His parole officer advised against it. But look at how he's done such a great job. Matt, thank you for inspiring me all the time. And I don't even want to talk about why you're not allowed to run a Cub Scout pack. It's just a pleasure to be on your show.
I do, and I've gotten used to the ankle bracelet. I've worked around with the fans on that. I'm so glad, and this is a huge deal, MSP. They're starting the tour here, and so we need to sell out Pantages. We need to get as many people in there as possible. It's just going to be great. I talked to you last time about this. The idea of you guys going on tour, because it's been so long. You've done some individual shows, but the full tour, this is just awesome.
We have not actually played in Minneapolis. I mean, we played the state a couple times. We played the Pantages before, but I don't think we've actually done a full show in Minneapolis since 2017. So it is really the time right now. If any of your listeners have ever been to one of these shows, they know that it's sort of like this unholy bacchanal of very depraved yet totally moral people. And it's the same thing. I used to call this tour like the blue collar comedy tour for smart people, because it's great to be in a room with a couple thousand other folks who feel the same way you do. Knowing there are no homophobes or transphobes or red hats in the room is an incredibly liberating feeling. And it's also just a really, really funny show with this election, which is the most important election of our lifetimes. Yeah. Just like the last six, we thought we've got to get back on the road and do a real tour. So for the first time, we're doing it with Live Nation, Mr. McNeil, and we're really thrilled it's starting off at the Pantages.
Well, and I had Frangela on yesterday, and they were talking about this. It's such a comfort, I think, not just Minneapolis. You're in Chicago, the Vic Theater in August. You're going to be going across the country. There's a comfort that comes with this, because you do sometimes question whether or not is this a consistent feeling across the country? Are the way I feel about how things are going, is this how a lot of people feel? And you guys coming into town, that's a comforting blanket. That's reassurance that that no, this is not just you. It's not just there. It's this is the country is basically sees this tyranny coming on out here, and we need to address it straight on.
Yeah, and you're not going to get that from the mainstream corporate media. I'm a big fan of mainstream corporate media, but at the end of the day, you know, journalists care about the truth. Media cares about ratings. And media likes their Trump-sized ratings. They also don't like the guy who wants to tax the billionaires. So we're not going to get any kind of even coverage in the media. And I don't trust the polls either. I'm sorry. I think polls these days are... They're polls of people who answer their landlines during dinner hours and polls of people who answer their cell phones when they don't know who's calling. I don't know, Matt. I don't think that's the most clear representation of the American electorate. So, you know, it's such an important election. There are so many forces at play trying to bring us back to the era of Donald Trump. He has promised to be so, so much worse. And I'm sorry, I think Roe v. Wade is going to just inspire so many more people to turn out and vote this time, to say nothing of the fact that they don't want a racist reality TV landlord who rapes people hiring judges. I don't care if Trump never goes to jail, Mr. McNeil. I don't want him picking any more judges.
You brought up two things. I want to tie them together and ask you about an issue or two, and this is Arizona. You did a whole podcast on there, so go listen to that. The Arizona ruling yesterday, Republicans try to act outraged by this. They're the ones who put these judges in place so they would rule this way. Yes. This is what they wanted to do. First of all, your thought on going back to 1864 to talk about any kind of health care language in any kind of bill.
Yeah. Okay. Well, first off, dogs who catch cars don't know how to be embarrassed. Right? Dogs who catch cars just get beaten up by the car and then they move on. But Donald Trump brought us the end of Roe v. Wade and national protection of abortion rights. And now his party, which is not the party of Lincoln, they are the party of John Wilkes Booth, and they are suffering a massive voter backlash, as you guys know. He thought he did something with his ridiculous little speech the other day, but now the Arizona Supreme Court said they have to adhere to this 1864 abortion ban, 56 years before women could vote, 110 years before women could have credit cards in their own name. And so this is what they're terrified of. For years, Matt, I will admit, I will confess, I thought the Republicans were using abortion as a vote racket, as a fundraising racket. I used to say, as long as politicians will have mistresses, abortion rights will be legal. And I was smug about it. I didn't think they would ever give up their cash cow. Because again, if Republicans wanted abortions to stop, they'd support easier access to birth control. They'd support sex ed in the schools. We don't have an abortion problem. We have an unwanted pregnancy problem and an abortion conflict over that. So I thought, oh, they're never going to let it. This is all a racket, you dumb MAGAs. And then when Mitch McConnell decided the first black president should also be the first president to not get an up or down vote on his duly appointed Supreme Court nominee, that's when I realized, oh my God, all bets are off. They really are trying to do this for real. And now they're seeing how stupid it really was. The American people don't support it. The Bible does not support it. Yes. The Bible is not against abortion. God is pretty much the least pro-life character in the book. At no point does God command government to incarcerate women. At no point is there any punishment for ending a pregnancy in the Bible. God asserts a fetus as property in Exodus 21. God gives abortion tips for unfaithful pregnant wives in Numbers chapter 5.
Yes.
One time, God killed every fetus on earth with a flood because he felt like it. And if you right-wingers really think God thinks children are innocent life, wait till you learn about Passover for the very first time. Lindsey Graham says, we can't have abortion because it's not in the Constitution. And I read it, and he's right. But it doesn't mention Lindsey Graham either, Matt. So we got to play it safe and ban Lindsey Graham too.
I should also mention something you pointed out before. New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Jesus multiple times praises women for making their own choices.
Yeah,
multiple times he does that.
Jesus is the biggest feminist in the Bible. Parts of that book are like the gospel according to Ike Turner. But I mean, the women are the only ones who don't abandon Jesus. The women are the first ones that he returns to. Again, you don't need to believe the story as literal fact to know that right-wing Christians are against everything Jesus talked about. He's not their Messiah. He's their mascot. And for a lot of these people, their actual religion is criminalizing abortion and pretending they're better than you. Jesus was against the death penalty, never mentioned abortion. The only way you can follow both Donald Trump and Jesus is if you've never read either one of their books.
There's an interesting element of the Arizona ruling, which I almost wonder is this the point of the setup? Have you noticed, I mean, Carrie Lake immediately comes on out and she's like, oh, this is an atrocious bill. It's like they're born again Democrats.
Yep.
And they're trying to make it seem like, well, we had this compromise 15-week ban. Let's go back to that. They're trying to portray this as they're the moderate vote. And as I pointed out, it's like, well, you're still regulating women's choices. Choice means choice. It doesn't mean we go back to your restrictions at 15 weeks.
Exactly.
But yet, this is across the country. There's this effort by the right to look at this. And I think to a point, we saw this with the in vitro fertilization ruling in Alabama, too, where, well, we're not that extreme. Yeah. Trying to sell their extreme light as moderate.
All damage control. That's all it is. You're exactly right. They know what they stepped in. It also shows they don't believe anything, Matt. Mm-hmm. I mean, look what Donald Trump did in his speech the other night. The two groups he needs the most, right, are the core evangelicals and the independents. Well, he said to the evangelicals, I'm not against abortion. If states want to have it, let them have as many abortions as they want. That pissed off that part of his base. And a smart Democratic billionaire like Mike Bloomberg might want to throw $1 billion into advertising the Right to Life party in 7 swing states. As long as RFK Jr. is going to be doing that, why can't we do it too? And then the independents, who don't want to see any kind of abortion ban in any state. So he completely stepped in it. But then Carrie Lake, who, you know, I've met Carrie Lake. I was doing a series for Fox, and I was in Arizona, and she interviewed me, and I was mystified by this woman. She was a Fox News anchor, and she said to me, but I voted for Trump, but I'm not a racist. I supported Obama. And I was like, so what? You decided one day that climate science was a myth and that billionaires have it rough and abortion should be illegal? She believes in nothing. She believes in nothing but how she can get more power. So she denounces the 1864 law. Last fall, she said she supported it. Then yesterday, she says she opposes the ruling. Then she demands that Governor Katie Hobbs come up with an immediate, what she called, common sense solution that Arizonans can support, which is words that mean nothing. Then she said the decision will be up to voters on the ballot initiative in November, which she actually is against. I mean, and no one asks her these questions. In the case of Donald Trump, he thinks he solved this. Someone needs to say to him, okay, so you think the state should decide, but if you're president and a bill banning abortion winds up on your desk, will you veto it? Do you really believe the state should decide? No one's asked Donald Trump about mifepristone and where he stands on that. I mean, these guys were just so greedy. They don't want to be Christian. None of them read the actual Bible. It's much easier to be anti-abortion and pretend you're better than other people. That's the real religion here. So they raced into this. Now they've done it. And now they've realized they're going to be unpopular for 2 generations. And this is going to drive so much voter turnout and so much more civic engagement. It's tragic they took Roe away, but I know a lot of good will come from this for women and for our democracy.
My daughter said, I had bodily autonomy when I was born and I don't have it now.
Yeah.
And that's something when your 20-year-old tells you that. The Florida, I wanted to bring in Florida as well. Rick Scott barely won that seat. Florida is not exactly a 20-point win for the right. They're going to have this abortion bill, on the ballot in Florida come election time. How much do you think that's going to impact Florida overall? I mean, they have to get to 60% to pass it, but I think you're going to get at least 5 to 10 points swing in one way or the other there.
Well, that's why it's really interesting now, because they don't just have the abortion bill on the ballot. They have the legalized weed bill on the ballot as well. So a lot of folks who might not have shown up to vote are going to be showing up to vote in the state of Florida. Now, I don't know if that's enough to put Florida in play. I don't know if that's enough to turn Florida purple, but it is enough to make the GOP spend tons of money they don't have defending a state they have taken for granted. And they don't have this money because Donald Trump has hired his untalented daughter-in-law to defile the RNC bank account like it's a Tom Petty song. And Laura Trump and her lip liner are going to be making sure that there's no money for congressional candidates at all in the RNC, because E. Jean Carroll needs to go shopping. And that's what's going to happen. You are going to be, when you donate to the RNC, the worst thing about it is you don't know, is this money going to Donald Trump's rape lawyer, or is it going to his criminal fraud lawyer, or his insurrection lawyer, or his theft of classified documents lawyer, or his RICO conspiracy lawyer, or his campaign finance fraud lawyer? Oh, and that one starts next week. They are going to, Donald Trump is a parasite on this party, sucking the blood out like a tick. And you're going to see a lot of candidates on the Republican side suffer because there's no money in the coffers, because it's been turned into Donald's personal legal GoFundMe.
I don't, do you think there's been any studies on how many people vote pro dope, turn around and vote anti-abortion? Because I don't think there's going to be a minuscule amount of those pro dope.
No, man, there's always going to be dude bros who only care about themselves and don't care about women's rights. And there's always going to be people who think, oh, anti-abortion, that's Christian. Just like, oh, anti-gay, that's Christian. Yeah. I mean, I talk a lot about the Bible in my act and on my show. And I always ask these Trumpers, give me one teaching of Jesus that MAGA fights for, that the Republican Party fights for. Give me one teaching of Jesus that conservative Christians fight for. The first answer I always get, Mr. McNeil, abortion, banning abortion. Then I tell him that's, the Bible's not against abortion. Judaism isn't against abortion. Abortions are legal and free in Israel right now. Second thing they'll say, Matt, they'll say, well, a strong border. Then I got to say, dude, the only law about immigration or borders in the entire Bible, Old Testament and New, is the commandment to welcome the stranger. Y'all are against Jesus on this one. So then they'll say, he moved the American embassy to Jerusalem. And that's when you've got to say, this may shock you, MAGA, but Jesus never mentions the United States of America or our embassy in the year 32 AD. Doesn't come up. I mean, they don't know the Bible. And the media is the villain here, because the media allows these charlatans to use Christianity as camouflage for their mean little club. And Democrats are afraid to call them out on their scriptural hypocrisy. And the media is terrified. Media's got to start asking these people questions about the faith they claim to follow. Because again, Jesus is just a prop they wave around. And I'm in the camouflage removal business, Mr. McNeil. Let them defend it on their own crappy terms.
We're going to get you some nice weather for when you're out here, man. It's going to be like 70 degrees, sunny skies. Going to be a nice weekend for you.
It's great. I'm going to be selling Bibles outside the theater for anybody. So please come on down. My Bibles are autographed. Does Jesus autograph his Bibles? I don't think he does. We don't have loaves and fishes. I'm going to be selling fish bowl tacos. That's what, fish bread bowl tacos. That's what we'll have. I mean, it's going to be a party over there, because everyone's sick of this. Everyone's embarrassed that we have to go through this pantomime again. And everyone's a little bit terrified that there might just be low enough voter turnout that RFK Jr. might be willing to never be invited back to Hyannisport again and throw this. So come on out. Let's have a big old party and let's get very excited to be engaged for the next 6 months.
Absolutely. It is at the Pantages Theater. It is coming up this Saturday night in Minneapolis. Not only is John going to be there, Frangela is going to be there, Hal Sparks is going to be there, Stephanie Miller is going to be there, Cliff Schechter is going to be there. We're looking forward to talking to Cliff on Friday. John, as always.
And Matt McNeil is going to be there as well. Can we announce this?
Yeah, sure. Yeah,
Matt McNeil will be taking the stage to welcome the rabble at the top of this show. So everyone, this is now your chance to actually try to grope Matt McNeil in person. Come on down. He will be coming up first, and he will be getting the crowd on fire.
Rotting fruit not allowed, FYI.
But they usually save that for my act. You'll be safe. Don't worry.
If you haven't seen John's act, it is brilliant. You're going to love, I mean, you're going to get four great talents out there. John himself would, it is worth every bit.
Oh,
of the
You're it too is. High.
Oh, you're too good, man. You are too good. John Fugel saying, Stephanie Miller, Sexy Liberal Show. Once again, Pantages Theater this weekend. John, as always, a pleasure to chat with you. The link for tickets, by the way, go to am950radio.com. We've got a link there. Go get your tickets right now. And John, as always, a pleasure to see you. I look forward to seeing you on Saturday.
I just want to say that Donald Trump is so disappointed in his media stock. He's now calling it Eric.
I think it's smarter than Eric still, though. John Fugel saying, John, thank you very much. I appreciate it.
See you this weekend.
See you this weekend, 952-946-6205. It is the Matt McNeil Show on your Wednesday.
Hey, it's Patrick for Zero Res. I'm going to get right into it. You should call Zero Res to beat the spring cleaning rush with big savings and priority booking by calling our cleaning heroes today. You should think about the dust, dander, and bacteria that's been breeding in your carpet all winter long with nowhere to go. And don't forget about your air ducts. If they're dirty, your air quality suffers. Indoor air quality is an issue year-round, but all that pollen is getting ready to come out of hibernation and into your home. This month, get 3-room Zero Resified starting at just $129 and take $75 off any air duct cleaning. You owe it to yourself and your family to breathe happy, healthy, and clean. Call 952-ZERO-RES or go to ZeroResMinnesota.com and ask for the AM950 special. Zero Res, backward or forward, spells the same.
Join Edina Rides for Education on Saturday, May 4th at Fred Richards Park for a leisurely 5 or 10 mile bike ride. Edina Rides is organized by the Rotary Club of Edina Morningside. Gear up for a day of community spirit. And here's the best part. Your Ride with Edina Rides supports local educational nonprofits like the Edina ABC program. Their goal is to increase the number of well-educated minority students and make it possible for deserving students to reach their full potential. Current student, Joyelle, a high school junior, says she's proud to be part of the Edina ABC program. She says it's been a joyous experience providing her with amazing opportunities from diverse classes to exciting events and meeting wonderful people. Your participation helps sustain organizations like Edina ABC. Registration is easy at edinarides.com. Take advantage of early bird pricing, just $25 for adults and $15 for kids. So gear up and pedal for a purpose on Saturday, May 4th with Edina Rides for Education. More at edinarides.com.
I'm having a really hard time lately, and I'm worried no one will understand what I'm going through.
I feel so alone. I wish there was somebody I could talk to.
If you're looking for support, Mental Health Minnesota is here for you, with connections to others who have also struggled with their mental health and can provide support and resources. Services are anonymous, confidential, free of charge, and open 7 days a week. Connect today at mentalhealthmn.org or call 855-HERE-4-MN today. Sponsored by Mental Health Minnesota, the Minnesota Broadcasters Association, and this station.
AM 950, the progressive voice of Minnesota. It's the Matt McNeil Show. 952-946-6205, 952-946-6205. So we've got to, since we're on Sexy Liberal, let me prepare you for what we're going about to do here when we come back from the next break. We are bringing back Wheel of Destiny. That's right. For all the people that interacted with the posts up on AM 950 Radio on Facebook, we are going to give away five pairs of tickets to go see Sexy Liberal this Saturday at the Pantages Theater. And on top of that, if you win one of those pairs of tickets, you're also going to win a pair of tickets to the pregame event over at On the Rocks, over the Nicollet Diner on 13th and Nicollet. On Saturday, starting at 4:30, I'll be there. The whole crew is going to be there. I get to go do some talkity-talky on the stage. I'm going to sweat a lot. It's going to be a fun, fun time. Ah, can I tell you? I love when the glands work. Anyway, so we're going to be doing this. We got that. And then on top of that, we're going to do Wheel of Destiny. I still today have a pair of tickets to give away for Sexy Liberal myself, not just on Wheel of Destiny. I'm getting my clickety, clickety, clickety ready to go. Not only on Wheel of Destiny, but I'm going to give away a pair of tickets, and with that pair of tickets, a pair of tickets to the pregame event as well. So in the next 30 minutes, I'm giving away six total pairs. This is chaos. When are you guys going to learn? I'm not like a regular radio guy. I can't. Fine.
fine. I'll make it work. I'll do my best. Oh, I'm so excited. And it is going to be fun. Now, and once again, I do, if I can, make sure I, and by the way, I'm not giving away those tickets right now. So if you're trying to call Patrick right now, phones just went, no. That giveaway is a little bit later on, all right? So we got Wheel of Destiny I got to do first. Hal Sparks is on the show tomorrow. How cool is that? I've never talked to Hal. I mean, it Carlos Alazraki was the last time they came through was Carlos was doing the shows. I have never talked to Hal Sparks. This is going to be so cool. That's in the 3 o'clock hour tomorrow. I've got to check with him. I think this is still a go. We'll have Cliff Schechter in studio for the full 2 hours on Friday. That's insane. That's insane. So I'm looking forward to this. And then, of course, we've got the big event on Saturday night. We're looking forward to this. Regardless of whether you win tickets or not, you want to go see this show. Frangela said it yesterday. John said it today. We had it when Steph was on. She said it too. This is this election, because Donald Trump got into office and was able to put three Supreme Court justices on the Supreme Court. Because of that, every freaking election, presidential, midterm, off year, every one of them matters. And they have, and this has been good. It seems like we have woken ourselves up from this stupor. And that ever since then, there has been just an absolute caboose kicking that has happened across the board on the Republicans. I'm not saying the Republicans haven't won, but almost every race has tightened up. Even their, you know, slam dunk races have gotten a lot tighter. There's a reason why Republicans in places like Texas are starting to recruit their church leaders to basically order women to vote the way your husband tells you to vote. You know, if you're an obedient wife, I'm serious. This is actually something that's happening in Texas. If you're an obedient wife, you will go on out there and vote the way your husband tells you to. Terrifying, freaking terrifying. But this is where they are. This is where they are. Everyone votes every single time. And your minor issues, and I'm not saying that, there are plenty of problems on the planet. I'll bring up Governor Walz. I was very upset with him when he passed line three. I'm very upset with him. But I was never crazy enough to think about voting for frickin' Scott Jensen. There's no sitting out. There is no other option. Joe Biden is the only guy in this election that's going to save this country. So you need to get out and you need to vote. For God's sakes, the Republicans in this state are trying to regulate chemtrails. Chemtrails! Or doing their best job to be an internet troll. I mean, it's just disturbing where this Republican Party has gone. So, simple, easy peasy. We vote every single election. All right. Patrick, let's take a break. When we come on back, let's do a little Wheel of Destiny action. 952-946-6205, 952-946-6205. It is the Matt McNeil Show here on your Wednesday. I said, you're holding back. She said,
shut up. Now at Woodland Stoves and Fireplaces, the new Lopi hybrid wood stoves.
Lopi wood-burning stoves in sizes and designs to fit your heating need and style choice. They not only feature a big, beautiful fire viewing area, they heat so efficiently that they qualify for the 30% tax credit. With this federal tax credit, you can earn $2,000 when you install efficient wood heating.
Lopi advances the technology of wood burning. EPA certified for clean burning, these new hybrids include refined catalytic combustor design. They burn not only cleaner, but longer and more efficiently. Lopi brings heating with wood into the 21st century.
Woodland Stoves and Fireplaces has been selling wood-burning products since 1977. We want to make fire work for you. Let us show you how Lopi wood-burning stoves can work in your home.
Get in touch with the folks at Woodland Stoves and Fireplaces. They are the chimney and insulation experts. Woodland Stoves and Fireplaces has over 35 working wood, gas, and electric units on display at the corner of East Franklin and Riverside Avenue in Minneapolis.
Greg Bakken here. I've told you about the out-of-the-world roast beef sandwiches at Maverick's Real Roast Beef, but I haven't told you about their Philly steak sandwiches, turkey bacon avocado sandwich, BLT, crispy chicken, fish sandwiches, brisket, or pulled pork. Okay, you get the idea. They make a lot of delicious food to the same standard as their famous roast beef sandwiches, and now I'm starving. I'm going to go to Maverick's Real Roast Beef off Lexington and Roseville, and you need to go too. Check out their menu at mavericksbeef.com.
Hi, I'm Scott Chambaud from Chambaud Family Dentistry. We're the fear-free, shame-free dental office. We know dental anxiety and dental phobia are real. We'll take the time to get to know you and give you what you need to be comfortable at all times. We offer free nitrous oxide laughing gas and have high-tech options to help you feel calm and relaxed during your appointments. We'll help you get through every appointment in the most pain-free way possible. If you're having a dental emergency, we'll try and get you in the same day you call, because we don't like to see anyone in pain. As my daughter Rachel says,
if you don't see my dad, please see another dentist. Take care of your teeth, because they're the only ones you get.
This is Chad, owner of AM950. I've been going to Chambaud Family Dentistry for years. They get me in last minute when I'm in pain and make regular checkups easy and comfortable.
Chambaud Family Dentistry in Hopkins and St. Paul. Find them online at ChambaudFamilyDentistry.com or call 1-800-FIX-MY-TEETH.
With AM950 weather, I'm Brett Johnson. Look for sunny skies today with a high near 71. Tonight, partly cloudy with a low around 44. And Thursday, a chance for rain with a high around 57. And make sure you go on our Facebook page and interact with one of our sexy liberal posts. If you do, you'll be entered into our Wheel of Destiny drawing, where you'll have a chance to win a pair of tickets to both our Sexy Liberal pre-party and the Sexy Liberal show. We'll do our Wheel of Destiny drawing today during the 4 o'clock hour. Again, go to AM950's Facebook page.
AM950, the progressive voice of Minnesota. It is the Matt McNeil Show. Oh, wow, I got the Wheel of Destiny on behind me here. One thing before we get to this here, I did want to make sure I give an update here from the Star Tribune talking about this. It is two injured deputies. One was treated on the scene and released. The other one was transported to the hospital, neither of them having life-threatening injuries. There is a line here. I want to read this. In police scanner audio, officers reported another person down on the ground and not moving. Asked about the person, Hennepin County Sheriff spokesperson Jeremy Zoss said to go to the BCA. BCA confirmed it was responding, but did not offer any details. I'm not sure if that was the shooter or what the case may be there. We'll have to see there. But once again, so far, the reports are the two Hennepin County Sheriff's deputies are injured, but they are expected to completely recover from that. It's not clear whether or not that area is still cordoned off. They have not released any information on whether the individual who is inside the house has been arrested at this point.
We do actually just have a break on that as well. Sheriff DeWanna Witt says the suspect is dead.
Oh, the suspect has been killed. All right. So that must be the individual that was on the ground. That would be my guess there. So obviously more on this to come, and we'll have more talk about this tomorrow, but I want to reiterate what I said at the beginning of this show. If you are pro cop, you have to be pro gun control. These officers went there to drop off a warrant and they got into a gunfight. And the reason why is there's guns everywhere and it's just crazy. And so all my best to the officers involved. And once again, if you are pro cop, you are pro gun control. That is the only position you can be. That is truly the only position you can be. All right. So Wheel of Destiny. Here you are. We have got the wheel here. It's got names on it. People that interacted with this post. Now we have got 5 pairs of tickets right now to give away to the Sexy Liberal show coming up here on Saturday at the Pantages Theater. With each pair of tickets comes a pair of tickets to the pregame warm-up over at On the Rocks on Nicollet Mall. So here are the Wheel of Destiny. We've got to do this 5 times. So Patrick, when you get the chance here, hit spin and let's go. There we go. Our first click, 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 click. Kevin Krenz, there it is. Kevin Krenz, guess what? You are going to be joining us on this upcoming weekend on Saturday for Sexy Liberal at the Pantages Theater. On top of that, not only do you get the pair of tickets, but you get yourself as well a pair of tickets to the pregame show over at On the Rocks. Congratulations, Kevin. You are in on that. Patrick, are we ready for the second spin? Clickety, click, 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 clickety, click, click, clickety, click, 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 click. There you go. Javier Trejo. Javier, guess what? You are going to join us on Saturday at the Sexy Liberal Show at the Pantages Theater. Not only are you going to do that, but once again, join us for the pregame event over at On the Rocks for that. All right, so there's number 2 down. Kevin, Javier, let's see who next is up on the click. Tony Kvale, K-V-A-L-E. Tony Kvale, Tony, guess what? You are going to join us. You have got yourself a pair of tickets to Sexy Liberal over at the Pantages Theater on Saturday night, as well as also you're going to get to the pregame as well, a pair of tickets for those. So congratulations on that. We ready for four? Let's hit it. Four. Here it is. Click. Oh, this is going to be a close one. It is a close one. Nina Andueza. Nina, guess what? You're joining us for the Sexy Liberal Show at the Pantages Theater on Saturday. There you go. Simple, easy. And we ready for five. Here's our last one. Click. David Milne. David, congratulations. You as well have won yourself a pair of tickets to not only the Stephanie Miller Sexy Liberal Save the World Comedy Tour at the Pantages Theater Saturday night, April 13th, but as well a pair of tickets to the pregame tailgate event over at this is going to be at on the Rocks at on the Nicollet Diner, 13th and Nicollet in Minneapolis. Congratulations to both all five of you there, Kevin, Javier, Tony, Nina, and David, all of you winning tickets today on Wheel of Destiny. On top of that, by the way, I'm going to say I still got a pair of tickets to give away. Listen for your chance to call in to possibly win on those coming up here a little bit later on. 952-946-6205, 952-946-6205. So I want to start off as far as topics today with something I talked about yesterday. And this is once again, the Minneapolis City Council vote Thursday on a measure to delay implementing minimum pay rates for Uber and Lyft drivers for 2 months until January 1st. Uber, which says it will lead the Twin Cities Metro if the rate takes effect, will stay for another 2 months at the enactment date is delayed, according to a spokesperson. Lyft, which plans to leave Minneapolis over the rates, did not immediately respond to requests for comment. The proposal to delay the implementation is intended to give alternative ride-hailing companies more time to enter the market and allow the council to track discussions and continue ongoing collaborations with state officials in their work to craft a statewide policy, according to news release from the council president, Elliot Payne, and council members, Katie Cashman and Oren Chaudhuri. They said the delay was negotiated with stakeholders and state officials. Uber and Lyft drivers are being paid a sub-minimum wage, and that is fundamentally wrong and goes against our shared values. We pass this ordinance because the current rideshare system is broken, and we are shocked to see the way that is leading to exploitative labor practices. Inaction was not and is not a choice. This ordinance is one step forward in correcting a broken system. Uber and Lyft drivers in the Twin Cities Metro earned an average of $30.27 an hour for the time spent logging into the app in 2022 before accounting for expenses. After accounting for expenses based on the federal base mileage rate of about 60 cents per mile, drivers earned an estimated $14.48 per hour for the time logged into the app, according to the study commissioned by the state. The study estimates drivers need to be paid 89 cents per mile, 49 cents per minute to earn the city minimum wage after paying their vehicle expenses and payroll taxes. The researchers also proposed the higher rate of $1.20 per mile, 49 cents per minute, which would compensate drivers for benefits like health insurance, paid family medical leave, retirement savings, and paid sick leave. Since they are treated as independent contractors, Uber and Lyft drivers aren't afforded the same benefits as regular employees. The council passed higher rates the day before the case study came out, $1.40 per mile and 51 cents per minute. They affirmed the support of the rates after the study came out, overriding Mayor Fry's veto of the ordinance. And I want to make sure it's very important to say this. This is a 22 cent difference when you're looking at difference per mile versus what was recommended versus what was passed, and the 2 cents per minute. And I'm going to go back to this. All right. So I imagine the standard drive in Minneapolis for an Uber or Lyft rider, let's say it's 4 miles. Say you're going from, heck, St. Louis Park into Minneapolis, that's about 4 miles. That's a buck extra, $1 extra. And you're making sure these people have a livable wage and they can afford health care and stuff like that. Why are we even having this freaking discussion? Seriously. And I don't need this. My family can't afford eggs. Well, that's the company is doing that. Your entire argument against this is that you feel as if certain workers should not get paid a certain quality of life. It reminds me of someone made a post about Waffle House. And they said, why don't we have Waffle Houses in a lot of states? And the reason why is because Waffle House is based on that Southern, pay standard where you pay people, what is it? In some states, it's like $2.70 an hour. Because their argument is, well, you get tips. And you see, this has been the entire argument on the Uber Lyft drivers is, well, you get tips. You don't have to get paid very well. You get tips. And then the study comes out and says, well, they're not getting tips nearly as much. That's why, by the way, whenever I took an Uber or Lyft in Chicago, it was Uber for me in Chicago, every one of them, I didn't care if I was just going around the downtown, $7 every time. $7 tip every time. Because that's being a decent human being. I mean, I was kind of stunned at some of the costs that I was seeing for the rides. That was, like $7 was the ride cost. I'm like, all right, if they're not getting tipped, they're not making any money. And once again, they're driving a car. I've talked about that before because I drove delivery for Domino's when I was a kid. And their argument was, oh, we're not going to pay you a good wage because you can write all this off on your taxes. They would tell you that to your face, knowing that you were nowhere near the mileage cutoff you needed to be. Maybe if you were a full-time pizza delivery guy, not a guy working some Friday and Saturdays, maybe the occasional NFL Sunday lineup. But if you were a full-time person and you drove all the time, you might get to that level. But the reality is most of us would never get close to that. And they told you that. They lied to you. They would lie to your face. And when you said, wait, you said this. Well, we never said this. You don't like the job. You can leave. It just really was. Yeah, it really was a incredibly disheartening experience to realize that there are a lot of people out there whose entire, as they make money, as they get successful, they're doing it breaking the backs of the workers. And they do it with a smile on their face. And if you dare say, well, should you pay these people a livable wage? How dare you? They know what they're getting into. It is why I'm convinced if you ever get a Republican who basically goes on out there and argue, when they're arguing to get rid of the minimum wage and they say, well, no one's not going to pay a decent livable wage. Of course they will pay crap wages if there's no minimum wage. There are just an insane amount of greedy jackasses out there that do not care about the fellow human. They're only in it for themselves. And that's just the reality. So it blows my mind when I get back to this Uber Lyft thing. You're talking about $1 extra basically per mile between what was recommended and what Minneapolis passed. $1 per four miles. Basically 22 cents per each mile. So an extra buck. No one cares. When you went and raised the salaries of people working in restaurants and people were like, it's going to cost you an extra $1.25 for your burger. No one's going out. No one cares. Restaurants are packed. No one cares. Restaurants are packed. You keep insisting The people, the reason why we are even having this discussion is it just tells you that the executive class of Uber and Lyft have so much sway over the politicians and leaders of this town that they basically say, well, if you have to pay a livable wage, we're going to leave. Let them go. And that's the other element of this whole thing, which I just don't understand. Why are you so betrothed to these people? You have plenty of rideshare apps who are out there right now frantically trying to get their paperwork together, trying to get their structure together, their finances together, to come in here and do it under this new salary system. And you guys seem to ignore that. I mean, the city council is saying, well, we're going to give some extra time for these people to get ready to go. But Jacob Fry seems to be like, no, that doesn't count. It has to be Uber and Lyft. No, it doesn't. Austin, Texas got rid of Uber and Lyft. They left. They set new standard rates for pay. And sure, there are a lot of people that don't do as, not nearly as many people do rideshare as they did before, but you can still get rideshare. It's slightly more expensive. Done. Because at the end of the day, I'm not a jackass who sits there and says, well, I expect some people to get a subhuman standard living cost of living rate for my needs. No, you don't deserve, they don't deserve that. And as a lot of people have pointed out, Jacob Fry talks about, oh, he wants to make sure people get wages, but he doesn't really talk about the plight of the drivers that much. I don't see the, I mean, if you're taking an Uber and Lyft from Blaine to the airport, okay, maybe you're going to get a few extra bucks in there. If they go through Minneapolis, because once again, this is a standard for Minneapolis. So if you take, you know, Highway 100 and scoot around the city and go down to the crosstown and cut across, you don't even go into Minneapolis, I don't think. I don't think the crosstown, I mean, well, you would have to over by Fort Snelling.
Yeah, because I think I'd have to go down to 494 because technically the crosstown cuts in when you're going between Portland and Cedar, it goes into Minneapolis.
Yeah, you're right. So, you know, so you go 100, Highway 100 down to 494, you completely avoid Minneapolis anyway. This seems like far more of a, like I said, I don't think we should have industries where we're not having people get paid. And then when people point out, well, they're not getting paid enough money, saying, well, it sucks to be them. No, we're not freaking Texas. We're not Tennessee. We're not Florida. We're supposed to be better than that. We're supposed to be. 952-946-6205. 952-946-6205. We'll take a break. Come on back. It is the Matt McNeil Show on your Wednesday. Boomer has it.
We are back and bigger than ever, baby. You're invited to Stephanie Miller's Sexy Liberal Save the World Tour. It's the comedy event of the year, and it's coming to a city near you. Join Stephanie with Sexy Liberals, Hal Sparks, John Fugelsang, and comedy duo Frangela for a hilarious ride as they heroically deconstruct the unfolding events of 2024 with an up-to-the-minute, side-splitting evening of comedy. Get your tickets now, live at the Pantages in Minneapolis, April 13th. Tickets on sale now at Ticketmaster.com.
The 2024 Consumer Reports Best Vehicle Edition is out, and Toyotas from Rudy Luther Toyota are the vehicles for long-term value. 7 of the top 10 most reliable vehicles are Toyotas. In gas mileage, 6 Toyotas are first place in their vehicle class, with the Prius being the best gas mileage vehicle overall. And if you want long-term reliability, Toyotas are some of the best at holding their overall reliability for years. This isn't a dealership hanging its head on one vehicle. Rudy Luther Toyota has an entire inventory of reliability. Get a Toyota today. Rudy Luther Toyota, 394 and 169.
Hi, this is Frank Brown, owner of Minuteman Press Uptown, Minnesota's only minority-owned union printing company. We have big news. We've moved to North Minneapolis.
Why did you move?
As a Black business owner, I wanted to be part of the North Minneapolis community to provide jobs.
Are there other reasons you moved there?
We have bigger new equipment and outgrew the other location.
What kind of new equipment do you have?
We have new equipment that allows us to print quality signage and banners. We also have a new inkjet printer, printing larger sheets, improving production efficiencies.
Is the new location easy to find?
It's not only easy to find, it's more convenient with plenty of parking. We are now located on Washington Avenue North off I-94 and the Dowling exit.
So do you still print everything?
We print more than everything. We have over 175 Google reviews with a 5-star rating. Call 612-870-0777 or visit mpuptown.com. That's mpuptown.com. We print everything. Baby, it's hard
inside. You're running across my mind. It is the Matt McNeil Show, 952-946-6205. I got that last pair. Let's give them away right now. It is Sexy Liberal over at the Pantages on Saturday. I got a pair of tickets for that. On top of that, I've also got a pair of tickets for you to, as well, to go to the pregame event over at On the Rocks on Nicollet, at the Nicollet Diner, 13th and Nicollet. So caller number five, let's do this. Last pair today, 952-946-6205, 952-946-6205. Caller number five, you will get yourself that last pair of tickets today for both the Sexy Liberal Show and the pregame event. Good luck. 952-946-6205. All right. Well, Patrick is dealing with that. Once again, let's talk about try that in a small town. Because apparently, once again, no crime ever happens in small towns, because that's what the country people in the far right like to make us think. Hey, wait a second. Here's a story. Authorities in Wright County are investigating a series of vehicle break-ins outside of rural churches. Wright County Sheriff's Office says deputies received reports of 13 victims reporting their vehicles were broken into outside of three churches on Sunday. Vehicles parked outside the Quarry Church in Monticello Township, the Connection Point Church in Buffalo, Evangelical Free Church in Buffalo Township were targeted. Victims reported damage to windows, in some cases items taken from their vehicles. In one of the thefts, an unidentified suspect pulled up to the scene in a silver Nissan Murano before approaching the victim's vehicle. All the incidents remain under investigation at this time. Stealing from churches. Didn't they tell them that you can't try that in a small town? Because apparently it's relatively easy for you to do. That's apparently three churches were hit. This is not necessarily, by no means am I condoning this kind of behavior. This is horrible. You're robbing people who's going to church. But it's not my narrative that bad things don't happen in small towns. I'll let you discover the meth problem yourself. It going on in a small town. That's what happens. But hey, that Matt, how dare you bring that? Okay, fine. That happened. Tell me something else, Matt. Yeah, in a small town. They're not going to try that in a small town. Oh, okay. Here we go. In Meeker County, that'd be small town territory. Authorities are hoping new photos will help investigate a suspect in an attempted child abduction in Meeker County. The Meeker County Sheriff's Office said the attempted abduction happened shortly before 8 p.m. Wednesday, April 3rd. I saw the story on this. This is terrifying. County Road 9, County Road 33 in the Stella Lake area of Ellsworth Township. In a statement shortly following the incident, the sheriff's office said a 13-year-old child told law enforcement a red Ford truck had pulled up at the end of the driveway. Man pulled them inside the vehicle. The child escaped the vehicle a short time later and ran to a nearby residence. On Tuesday, the sheriff's office announced that they received surveillance footage. So obviously you have to ask yourself the question, is the kid, you know, is this true story? Apparently it is. Indeed, they found surveillance footage of the vehicle matching the description of the truck involved in the incident. The footage shows a red truck traveling westbound on County Road 33 during the time frame of the April 3rd incident. There's also video surveillance of what appears to be the same truck driving slowly and repeatedly on the 217th Avenue of County Road 33 the night before the attempted abduction. In Tuesday's statement, the agency said detectives believe the vehicle is a late model Ford F-150 pickup truck. Now, I, as a heathen metro person, I'm going to make sure I post this story. There is links there. I want you to look at those photos. If anyone who is listening to my show knows who that truck is, I want you to call Meeker County Sheriff and get in touch with them right away, because you think this guy has stopped. No, he's just moved to a different area. But you see, is the point I want to make is this. You guys on the in these rural areas trying to make it seem like nothing bad ever happens. Try that in a small town. They're trying that. And while you guys are so damn hyper-focused on black people in North Minneapolis, this crap is going on in your town. And how many times do people commit crimes right in front of your faces and you don't see it because it doesn't fit the narrative you want to be true? Wake the F up. All right. All right. All right. Patrick, if I may, who is our winner today?
Eric from Minnetonka. Congratulations. You're headed to the Sexy Liberal Tour and the party beforehand.
And nicely done. All right. So here's the deal. And by the way, Kevin and Javier and Tony and Nina and David and Eric, a lot of winners today. My clickety click voice is starting to go. Here's the deal. I got one more pair of tickets to give away sometime during the show tomorrow. One more pair. Your last chance to win tickets to Sexy Liberal and the pregame event at On the Rocks. That is tomorrow. All right. All right. Last chance. Good luck. I'm not going to tell you when we're going to call on in. Hal Sparks, by the way, also going to join us tomorrow at the beginning of the show in the 3 o'clock hour. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Native Roots Radio is coming up next. We are back tomorrow. Until then, see ya.
The NLS Braille and Talking Book Program gives patrons the freedom to read their way, listen to their stories.
When I lost my sight, the only thing I had was reading, and it was like therapy to me.
NLS has pretty much anything you possibly want to read, just can't recommend it enough. It's a free service. It's amazing how much you can get.
I have used every means there is, I think, of getting access to the National Library Service books.
If you want to read in electronic braille, you can. If you want to read on your phone, you can. If you want to read in hard print, you can.
Everybody can read the way they want to read using this program, and it's a program worth looking into.
For more information about the National Library Service for the Blind and Physically Handicapped Library of Congress, visit loc.gov/thatallmayread or call 1-888-NLS-READ.
I'm standing up for the middle class. Tom Hartman here on the Progressive Voice of Minnesota, AM 950, KTNF, St. Louis Park, Minneapolis, St. Paul.
AP News, I'm Ben Thomas. The top U.S. general in Europe has